You're watching UNICEF television.
Look beyond Panama's famous canal, and you'll find a world where an estimated 55,000 children are working, in the streets, on farms, in fisheries, and other areas. Beginning at age 9, Juan Carlos Quintana spent many years working a series of jobs. Then one day, he was approached by someone from Casa Esperanza, a UNICEF-supported organization committed to reducing child labor in Panama. It's helping some 5,000 children like Juan Carlos get back in school.
I have been coming to Casa Esperanza for 6 or 7 years. When I first came here, I was small and very shy. They helped me with my homework, and I'm part of different workshops where I learn different skills. And whenever I can help out other people, I do.
Casa Esperanza is also helping families in extreme poverty pay school fees while providing their children with a meal during their time at the center. UNICEF supports Casa Esperanza financially, along with technical assistance. The projects receiving help from UNICEF include a violence prevention campaign in urban areas.
The stories we have here are beautiful, are marvelous. We have children who work in the street, who live below the poverty line. Many of them are sick and have problems at school. Casa Esperanza takes them in and includes them in our programs. The best thing to see is years later when you see children now at the head of their class, children who want to become lawyers or doctors to help other people in their own area. They become intelligent community leaders. Children who have dreams, who say it's not important how I got here, I'm going to rise up because many people believe in me.
By helping these children realize their rights, especially their right to an education, Casa Esperanza is making their world safer, happier, and more likely to be free of the poverty that most of them have known their entire lives. This is Thomas Nybo reporting for UNICEF Television in Panama City, Panama. For more information, go to unicef.org. Unite for children.